All right, guys, so in this video, there's going to be tons and tons of updates. I haven't posted in a long time, so I have a ton of stuff to tell you guys about. So stay to the end of the video and take the journey with me. Alright, so as you guys may have noticed, those of you that watch my videos all the time have realized that we haven't been around much. And there's a lot of reasons for that. There's a ton of reasons for it. There's some health reasons, not my health, but a friend's health, that forced us to kind of take some time off. And then we've also been super busy here. You know, this Jeep thing has just gotten legitimately out of control. To the point where I'm having a hard time keeping up with it. And I've been seriously contemplating hiring somebody to come and help out with all this stuff. So with that being said, videos have kind of been put on the second burner, the third burner, the fifth burner. I don't know, one of those burners. But it wasn't a priority. Getting the work done, getting things in process, and getting things in here and out of here quickly and as efficiently as possible has been the process. But during that time, there's also been a ton of changes in the shop. There's been a ton of changes in the way that I do things. There's been a ton of changes in the equipment. There's been a ton of changes in the vehicles that are going in and out of here. There's been tons of changes in the shop building itself. So figured I'd make a video because I haven't talked to you guys in so long and just kind of take you through the shop, the changes, everything that's been going on and everything that's going to be going on in the future. And by the way, one of the biggest changes right now is we are using a brand new camera. For years, I filmed this entire channel on GoPros. I don't know if you guys knew that or not, but the original videos on this channel were filmed on a GoPro session. The little square tiny cube deal was filmed on that. Some of the videos were filmed on a G7X. Some were filmed on a GoPro Hero 7 or 6. I think I went from the 6 to the 8 to the 9. And then always used the session for time lapses and stuff like that. So this channel's been almost entirely filmed on $500 GoPros. But the unfortunate part about what I'm doing right now and the way that I wanted to make videos is that the GoPro itself is a great camera for putting it in the situations where you wouldn't want to damage a better camera, but then you also don't have the control over it. Film's great in 4K, but it does overheat. And so in a hot environment where I'm welding and doing all kinds of stuff and the shop is super hot, that can be an issue. You know, when you're in the middle of filming a large video and the camera keeps shutting off because it's too hot, and then you got to figure out how to cool it down. And then, you know, the GoPro microphones are notoriously bad. So I have to wear a wireless microphone all the time. But if I'm cutting and grinding and welding, I don't want to ruin the wireless mic, so I don't wear it. But I think what we're going to do now is we're going to use the GoPros for the stuff that the GoPros were intended for, the dangerous stuff, you know, filming the welding because the bright light actually damages the sensor right there and that guy. And there's a bunch of other things that we can use the GoPros for, time lapses and just having a small camera, whatever. But right now we're actually using a Sony ZV-1, which with all the accessories and everything is about $1,000 camera. So we kind of stepped it up just a little bit, nothing crazy. But then again, I don't want to be running a $2,000 or $3,000 camera in a dirty, dusty, metally, rusty shop environment. So the ZV-1 was perfect. It's got a built-in lens. We don't have to worry about lens changes. We don't have to worry about dirt getting into the body of the camera and all that. So the ZV-1 should do exactly what we need it to do. So that's the number one change, new camera for the channel. Number two change is all these videos have been edited on a 16-year-old HP twin Xeon processor server machine that I bought for $200 years ago. Now all the videos are going to be edited on a 2012 Mac Mini, which kind of funny. Not necessarily an upgrade, but not a downgrade. It's much newer. I managed to get it to run Big Sur. It's got maxed out RAM, maxed out hard drive, and I think it's going to do well for editing these videos. Plus, it'll make things easier too, because then I can use my phone for videos and just airdrop the videos to the Mac instead of having to go through the process of trying to extract video files off of an iPhone. It's a pain in the butt. But that'll be the next change. And now I think we'll get up and walk around a little bit, and I'll show you guys some more of what's been going on. All right, so a huge upgrade has been this little guy right here. And for those of you that don't quite know what that is, that's air conditioning. The shop is now air conditioned because it gets a little hot in here. Especially in the dead of summer when it's 95 degrees and, you know, we're wearing that leather jacket and everything else that goes along with it and then generating a ton of heat, tends to get super hot. So work wasn't getting done and we got a lot of it. So we needed something. So yes, the shop is air conditioned. What do you guys think of my my CAD work there? You know, the old cardboard aided duct work? Works for now. Eventually I think we're going to put some spiral right across the top here and then duct it out into the shop. But for right now, the cardboard is working beautifully. So that was one thing that we had gotten going this year. Not much has really happened with the El Camino. I kind of got a color that I really like on it. It's olive drab green. I'm kind of digging it. Then, of course, we have yet another Jeep up here, which we have probably six more Jeeps, I think, out somewhere. So we're definitely doing Jeeps like crazy. And this one, you know, has your typical rot in its typical spots and was undercoated. Again, the lovely undercoating of the Jeep Wranglers, which drives me absolutely crazy. Hate that stuff. So,
but yeah, so there's been a ton of stuff going on in the shop, a ton of updates, a ton of, you know, just normal everyday business. And I don't know if you guys are interested in this, but I mean, I can even make videos where we get into a little bit of the day-to-day operations of a business and a business like this where you're doing work that pretty much no one else does. It gets a little crazy. So I don't know. Let me know what you think down in the comments about maybe getting a little bit more insight into what goes into running a business like this on a daily basis. Okay, so one of the things that I've been wanting to do for this channel and with this channel for a long time is education. I'm very big on educating people. I don't hold back any type of knowledge. I know there's a lot of people in this industry that tend to kind of hoard knowledge and then hold on to it. And when you ask questions, you get the cold shoulder. I've dealt with it for years because I'm always interested in learning about something new. And I thought that I could bring some of my knowledge to you guys. So what I want to do in the future is have you guys either hit me up on my Instagram or shoot me a comment down below this video with ideas about things that you want to know about. And I'm not talking just, you know, welding or repairing Jeeps or frame repair or anything like that. I'm talking anything. There's a wealth of knowledge that I have. My career has spanned over several different industries. And there's a ton of knowledge that I have, whether it be automotive diagnostics, telecommunications, fire and flood restoration. There's been a ton of stuff that I've done that I've learned, and I'm always seeking new knowledge as well. So if you have an interesting topic that you think I'd be interested in, then, you know, hit me up with that too, or have me look something up. But I want to educate. I want to educate everybody out there. I want to educate people who want to know something. If you want to know something and I know it, I want you to know it as well. So that's how I've always been. And you know, sometimes to a fault, because I tend to sometimes educate people who didn't ask to be educated, which, you know, it is what it is. But at least they know that information at that point in time. So should be an interesting little thing. But one of the goals that I've always had in my life is to educate. And I was an educator for several different companies. I was an instructor for various operations within those companies. So let me know down below in the comments, what would you guys like to learn? What do you guys want to know? Are you interested in automotive stuff? Are you interested in welding and metallurgy and things of that nature? Are you interested in operations of a business? Or, you know, maybe dogs. I have, you know, my Morty always upstairs. let me know. And maybe we'll make some videos on specific items that I can research and do some educating on, because I think it would be super interesting to be able to give some of the knowledge that I have back to you guys, and especially my younger audience. My younger audience, you know, I get messages from you guys and comments all the time about things that you want to know, things that you want to learn. And I also get a ton of comments on my YouTube channel from, I don't know how to put this nicely, but uneducated commenters who comment on things as though they're experts. However, they're not, and they can... There's been times where I've had to actually respond to a comment because what that particular comment was stating to do was dangerous and not something that should be done by anyone else. So a lot of times I see those and I'm like, oh God, if somebody reads that comment and is unaware and uneducated on that subject, could potentially get hurt very badly. So that's some of the things that I really want to do. So before I beat this topic to death, just go down in the comments and let me know if there's anything that you guys want to learn about. And if I know it, I'll be more than happy to make a video about it. So other than that, everything else with the shop has been crazy. Crazy. We also have some new stuff in the works with another company that may want to bring me in to start a vehicle program for them. And it just this year has been a crazy year for opportunity and growth. So I'm super thankful for it. And I'm super thankful for all you guys for, you know, sticking by me the entire time. Even when I wasn't posting videos, you guys are still on those videos every day and still commenting when I post a new video. So for you guys, I definitely appreciate all that stuff. I hope you guys are enjoying some of the Yes Welders that you may have purchased from watching my videos. I definitely appreciate that too. Yes Welder has been an amazing company. They've worked with me now for almost 2 years. And they've been supplying quality products that I still use every day. You know, and it's like I've said before on my channel, if it's trash, either you guys don't see it or you'll see me throw it in the trash. And 2 years now, I've been using nothing but Yes Welder products. Got rid of my ESOB, got rid of my Miller. And a lot of people say, you're crazy for doing that. But let me tell you something, the technology now has greatly improved the quality and reliability of these more inexpensive pieces of equipment. And if they survive the beating that I put them through on a daily basis, they're definitely going to survive just home gamer use and hobby use. And you know, someone who's just learning how to weld, you know, if you're just getting into the hobby and you're not sure if you're going to like it or not, there's no sense in spending $2,000 on a MIG welder when you can go to Harbor Freight, Yes Welder, and the several other companies out there that are making halfway decent welders for next to no money. You can get an entry-level MIG welder now for under $300. And that to me is insane, because the first MIG welder that I bought was an entry-level Miller, and it was almost $1,000 for a 140-amp, 110-volt welder. And now you can get a 250 amp welder for $500. That's going to be beautiful for doing all the stuff you need to do. So that's been absolutely amazing. Partnership with them has been great. And thank you to all you guys who have ordered from them. I do get a small commission every time you guys order from them, but it also gets the word out there that there are better machines out there that are still cost effective, you know, and they're not cheap per se, which is huge. So let's see, what else? What else we got going on? I don't know if I showed you guys this guy, but that's the engine that's going to be going into the El Camino. It's a 454 that we're going to be doing some interesting work to try to bring it to life and make it right for what I want to do. I like to be different. I like to be unique. And sometimes that means waiting a little bit to get the parts that I want, the things that I want. And we'll be working on that hopefully this winter when things hopefully slow down a little bit with the Jeeps, but I'm not 100% sure that that's going to happen because it's still super crazy. If you guys have emailed me, if anybody has emailed me and you're watching this video and I haven't gotten back to you yet, I sincerely apologize. But like I said, I'm spending Mondays doing nothing but answering emails and running around like a chicken with his head cut off. Tuesdays, I'm trying to get as much work as I possibly can get done in a day done. Wednesdays is more running around, more answering emails. Thursday is working maybe a little bit if I can actually get to it. And Friday is usually everyone in the complex decides they need something fixed. And I seem to be the only guy in the complex with tools for said fixes that are needed. So that's what ends up happening on Fridays. Weekends have just been a wash lately. And yeah, it's tough to keep up with. So I'm seriously considered bringing someone in here to not only help film, but to help do the work on all these Jeeps and, you know, everything else we got going on here, because it's crazy. It's absolutely crazy. And, you know you guys feel it. Anybody that's out there that owns your own business, you know how that goes. You know, I personally struggle with self-discipline issues. You know, getting up in the morning and actually going to work on time and then performing said work during the day without getting distracted is a little difficult for me. So I have to push myself pretty hard to overcome that. But anyway, I'm sure this video is probably, 10, 15 minutes long. But I just wanted to come on here and give you guys an update. I've got so much stuff in the works and I've got so many things that I want to film and absolutely no time to do any of them. So I sit here in my chair talking to you guys in hopes that you will, one, motivate me, two, give me some ideas on what you guys want to learn, and three, just sticking with me is amazing. I really appreciate it. So I'm going to wrap this one up because I could literally sit here and talk for hours, and I know you guys don't want to hear that, but I could. So leave your comments down below. Let me know if you guys are interested in learning anything and interested in me even putting together maybe some educational videos for you. And I don't know. We'll go from there. We'll see you soon. I got another Jeep coming in here. And I also have another Jeep that I may go film in a little bit. I actually had the first Jeep ever that I turned away. The first one that was beyond my repair. And you guys might find that one interesting. I think I still have it here in the yard. I'll have to check. If it's still in the yard, I'm going to go film it, and I'll show you guys the whole reason why I condemned this Jeep and was the first one ever I could not repair. So, on that note, have yourselves a wonderful afternoon. I'll see you guys on the next video, which I have to get my money's worth out of this new camera now, so we're going to make sure that we use it quite a bit. And now that we're sitting in this wonderful air conditioning, it's pleasant. It's pleasant to make videos. So I'll see you guys all in the next one. Have yourselves a wonderful day, and keep learning.